How's it going, everybody? This is Beat the Bush. Today, I'm going to talk about the healthcare cliff and how just earning $1 over the limit can cost you up to $10,000. Now, the Affordable Care Act operates on the federal poverty level, which is set by the federal government every single year. 100% of federal poverty level is roughly $12,000. So therefore, if you have an income of $12,000 every year, if you earn less than this, you'll be considered in poverty. Now, the fine point I want to talk about today is the 400% federal poverty level, because if you go $1 over this, you will get zero subsidies from the government. Now, anywhere between the 100% federal poverty level to 400%, which is $48,000, you get a varying range of subsidies and you can expect to pay for healthcare roughly the same amount no matter what age you are. However, if you make just $1 over the 400% federal poverty level, you're going to end up paying in full price for your healthcare costs. Now, I made a video about marginal tax rate before where I said if you make $1 over your tax bracket, you're essentially not gonna get billed like thousands of dollars, because when you move into a new tax bracket, it's only that additional amount that gets taxed more. You don't get taxed more for your entire income. With this Affordable Care Act cliff, it's a lot different, because if you just earn $1 more over, you're gonna end up paying thousands of dollars more depending on your age. So imagine a scenario where you made $1 less than the 400% federal poverty level, roughly around $48,000. Your premium would end up being $388 no matter what your age is. However, the real cost of that healthcare is about $401 when you're age 20, and it ramps up all the way to $1,240 when you're age 65. As you can see in this chart, if you just make $1 less than the federal poverty limit, you're gonna get more and more subsidies as you get older. When you're age 20, you'll get about $156 of subsidy that year. But when you're at age 65, you're essentially getting about $10,212 worth of subsidies. Now, you'll only get the subsidy if you make less than that 400% poverty level. So it becomes a very, very strange situation if your earnings hovers around this $48,000 mark. Imagine the scenario where one guy made $1 over the 400% poverty level and they end up having to pay full price for the healthcare costs, which is $10,000 more suddenly. When you're making $48,000, assuming that your take-home pay is roughly $40,000, an additional $10,000 bill is essentially 25% of your income, basically. This is extremely taxing for someone making right around that amount. You can imagine a different scenario where if a person is making $58,000 and they're working really hard all year long and they're on an hourly pay, what happens is this person can essentially just not work for 2 months of the year and just go, no, you know, they're not gonna make any more money. This person can essentially not work 2 months out of the year just to make sure their income stays under the 400% poverty level. I am just pointing this out because this is a real issue and people do actually do this. They don't want to pay extra if you don't have to. Now, not everyone's gonna have a cliff of $10,000. If you look at the age range, it ramps up. At age 25, it's a cliff of $324. At age 40, it's a cliff of $1,680. At age 50, it's a cliff of $4,200. So you can imagine, depending on your age, you may choose to not work a certain amount in order to make less than this limit. This is just the way it is right now. And in order to prevent people from not working extra in order to get more government subsidies, what can be done is to structure this subsidy so that it's more gradual and not a sudden huge cliff like this. So what they can do here in order to avoid this huge cliff is essentially give a cap at 500% poverty level, 600% poverty level, so that when you earn 500% federal poverty limit, you're essentially going to have increasing healthcare costs up to a certain age, and then it's gonna get pegged and flat lines out. Same thing with 600% federal poverty level, where it would just ramp up all the way and then it would cap really high up. So I think having more levels here would help in this cliff all the way up to 1,000% federal poverty limit, because if you are earning 1,000% federal poverty limit, this is essentially $120,000 a year, and you should be able to afford $1,000 worth of healthcare every single month by then. So I don't know where I'm actually going with this. I don't actually hope for, you know, the government to take a look at this YouTube video and change it or anything. But when I look at this huge cliff at age 50 or so, this is a really huge concern for people. And having this cliff there is just a really big a nuisance, I think. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and this is the way it's structured, and this is the way people are going to take advantage of it. People will try to make it underneath that 400% 400% federal poverty level in order to get that subsidy. In order to avoid this situation, you need to apply more rules like the method I just described. If you're interested in supporting my channel, check out my Audible link down in the video description below where you can get a free audiobook. And if you don't like this audiobook or this service, you can cancel it before the subscription expires. And you can still keep this audiobook and help benefit this channel. I also have a Patreon over here where you can chat with me directly and privately about financial matters. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel over here and click that bell icon next to that subscribe button so that you get a new notification whenever I upload a brand new video. Thanks for watching.